There's one YouTuber that I do not like. Like, I just don't like. It is H3H3. I don't like him. He's a backstabber. He's backstabbed Felix twice. Leafy is here once. Pyrocynical once. Keemstar once. And, you know, I would say he deserves a content cop. But if you don't know who does content cops, it's one of my favorite YouTubers, iDubbbz. He's still a good YouTuber. I'm not saying he's a bad YouTuber, even though he's a simp. Once he gets out of this, like, state where he's at, no, right now, called a simp, he'll be able to produce a content cop, because he'll have that moral high ground. And H3H3, and see, if he did make it right now, he would become, he'd come off as a huge hypocrite. Because he would be backstabbing, and one of the main points he'd put out is H3H3 is a backstabber. He's done it multiple times. He's probably going to do it to multiple other people in the future, and I think he just deserves it. But, see, it wouldn't work, because those two are friends, but say Ethan backstabs him, boom, easy. That gives Ian the idea to just use his invisible lasso and basically shoot his channel down. Because if iDubbbz makes a video about him, Ethan would be basically the size of me. He'd be like 10 subscribers, because 99% of his audience is also an audience of H3H3. They're connected very easily, actually, by a very large portion. And if they did, it wouldn't be a good idea. It'd make a lot of drama, and I'd be able to make profit off of that. But I wouldn't do that, because I'm not here for money. I just like making videos. But it'd make me a lot of money saying that. And it'd make a lot of drama, because it'd basically be a clash of the titans. They're huge channels. They're like the 5 to 6 million subscriber range. That'd be like having, well, we already had that battle, but like Leafy is here in his prime versus Pyrocynical in his prime. It'd be a battle. Those two were both huge commentators and had same backstories. They would just be a clash. And, you know, I think it'd be a very fun thing. I would obviously take iDubbbz side. I like his content a lot better. Ethan's content is more making fun of bad YouTubers, and in every way, Ethan classifies. He's making horrible content. You know who Ian has made content cops on? Jinx, bad content. Beefy is here, relatively bad content. I watch his channel, so I can't say it's really bad content when I watch his channel. Who else? Keemstar, he was a backstabber, which, Leafs here was kind of a backstabber, and Tanamongu, a liar. Now, those, if you put those all into a thing, that's basically a lizard. Do you know who else has all those traits? Ethan Klein. It just, the stars will align one day, Ethan Klein will accidentally backstab him. It will be bad. It will be horrible. And it will not work well. It will be bad. It will not be good. Nothing good will come out of it, because it will just, well, I mean, it'd be good, because a lot of content creators like me, who are small and do reports on drama and stuff like that, we would get a stand and we could grow as a channel. See, I have friends who make content, but not that type of content. They make Roblox content and Fortnite content. Oh, dap, dap, dap. I make more advanced content that would classify it to regionalize that. And if I regionalize that, it will be a lot easier. And then I could get a lot of subscribers. You know, that'd be pretty cool. My subscriber goal is like 100,000 subscribers. Because I, honestly, I kind of want to be like Ian. Sorry, I know I look like Pyro Cynical before he had the YouTube channel. And it would be just like, I'd just love to see it. Because if either way, those two things are hugely connected, there's a huge gap. And if one of them just shoots at the other, it's gonna stir up a lot of controversy. Sorry for my hair looking bad. It would be like, it'd be like PewDiePie going up against Jacksepticeye. They have a huge connection of subscribers. And it would end. And whoever makes the video first and whoever has the most backed evidence, and then whoever has that, they will have the more subscribers after a while. And see, I know this system. I have online classes. Yeah, we have online classes now, so that's pretty epic, isn't it? Wow, hey guys, look, I'm a balding man. This is gonna be my main trick doing online schooling. Bald. Now I'm probably just gonna sit there like, I'm gonna sit in this seat and be like, oh, and I, don't worry, I'll make a video while it's going on. Because I'm that much of an epic gamer. So there will be a video going on. I'll have one thing here, and it'll just be awesome, you know? I'll be a new strand of content, and that type of content gets really good on Reddit. It gets a lot of Reddit karma, and once again, it'll come back to me. So, and I'll be original content, because I haven't seen that anywhere. Oh, and you know what? I'm gonna make a video on it. Taylor Swift made a song, a new song, about a month ago that I didn't catch up on. The Man.
I would be complex, I would be cool. They'd say I played the field before I found someone to commit to. That would be all.
I know I'm gonna get copyright now, but it's, there's, they went for the BuzzFeed route. Oh. Man spreading. She showed a picture of him with a suitcase between his legs, and then his leg outstretched on a public area. No man does this. Like, literally no man I have ever known has done that, because it's just the douchiest thing to do. There's no man that does that. And it really helps your point when right next to them is a man, which your point is set in that. Sitting with his legs like this, and no, I meant don't sit with their legs like right next to each other. It crushes their balls. Like, the one thing they need to reproduce is being crushed if they're in a tight area. And you know that, like, man spreading chair, that one where it has like this, and then like they have to sit in a certain way? That is just like going to kill men. That is like killing men, bruh. Every week there's a different chair. One that had like this. And then like this, so it was had no support in the back, but it held up by tilting that way. Stupid. And I was like, bro, it was so dumb. Because it also implies that women would have their genitals stretched like this, which is basically what they did for the Olympics in this. No, in like. Runs in the 1600s in medieval times, they would have women outstretch their legs to show they have a a cat. And that cat would be used. And then, yeah, they just do that. And that would, and it would stretch their cat. Every time I say cat, here's a new game. Every time I say cat, put a bullet in your soul. Just don't actually do that. I don't want to be responsible for multiple people dying. Take a shot every time. Or if you're a child, drink a gallon of water. I don't know. Just go to bed for 2-10 minutes. And if men do that, their kitties that would then send sperm to the urethra to produce and fertilize the female egg would burst. And you know what that means? That would end humans. Wouldn't that be fun, guys? Ending all human life. Because we humans don't have brain cells. I'm gonna get this video to exactly 11 minutes 23 seconds. I don't know how, but I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna stretch and talk and la 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 la. Bye.